Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome aboard Double Sunshine for this morning's 10 a.m. sightseeing cruise. My name is Dan. I'll be your captain at the helm this morning. Our mates are Dean and Rob. I want to give you folks some information regarding the Double Sunshine prior to our departure from the dock. The Double Sunshine is equipped with both adult and children's life jackets on board. On the lower deck, we do have 27 adult life jackets located directly underneath the seat in front of the Dolphin Mural and the stern pillows. This time, for those of you that did listen, you can get up now and walk around the boat. We have left the dock at Tin City. Give you a little bit of a background regarding historic Tin City. In the 1920s, this stretch of the Gordon River was the hub of Naples' fishing industry. Its old Florida tin top buildings were home to clamshell and oyster processing, boat construction, and boat maintenance. In the 1970s, seven of these old sturdy buildings were transformed to become the old marine marketplace at Tin City, a colorful maritime themed mix of shops and eateries. Today, Tin City is home to three unique buildings with a waterfront boardwalk that's full of activity with more than 30 charming boutiques, two waterfront restaurants, Adventurous Crab Shack, and the Riverwalk Restaurant. We lie here in the Gordon River with Naples Bay directly in front of us. We're approximately 2¾ miles from Gordon Pass, which is the junction that separates Naples Bay and the Gulf of Mexico. Before we do make our way out into the bay, I do want to call your attention to this piece of land on the left side of our boat. This piece of land is actually an island. It's appropriately named Naples Island. Naples Island does bisect the right side is the Naples City Dock. The city dock is located at the east end of 12th Avenue South in a section of town called Creighton Cove. Creighton Cove does have a number of specialty shops, including the Naples Ship Store, Brigadoon, Sphere, Norma Butler Designs, and White Space Art Gallery, as well as restaurants such as Bender. Now on the forward right side of our boat, we are approaching what is the first of three waterfront communities that are built on the shores of Naples Bay. And the name of this community is Aqualane Shores. Aqualane Shores does begin at 14th Avenue South in Old Naples. It continues in a southerly direction, ending at Jamaica Channel. We'll be talking about Jamaica Channel a little bit later in our cruise. But Aqualane Shores was originally founded in 1949 by Forrest Walker when Mr. Walker purchased 294 acres of land in Old Naples for the sum of $30,000. It took Mr. Walker nearly 14 years to develop Aqualane. You see, all of the canals in Aqualane Shores are man-made. They were personally dredged by Mr. Walker and his son, Lorenzo. Once all the canals were dredged and the land subdivided, we are approaching a beautiful stone home that is built on a point that overlooks a portion of the bay. This beautiful stone home is presently owned by Mr. Jack Antaramian. If any of you folks happen to be staying at either
Bayfront in Naples or at Naples Bay Resort. You may have indirectly contributed toward the purchase price of this home. It's because Mr. Hunter Ramium is the developer of both Bayfront and Naples Bay Resort. He did purchase this home nearly 3 months ago at a cost of $16 million. Now, on the left side of our boat, you'll notice this small island. This tiny island is named Shell Island. It's a pretty island.
I see George, and okay. I see recording. Herb.
You got it?
It's on yellow right now.
Well, it says RE something on there. Well, stand by. Let me see what you got. Yeah, REC right there.
I can't see that.
Okay, you generally do 10-second segments.
Yeah, you don't do long.
It's a little but it's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Spy boy meets spy boy, and big chief meets big chief of town.
Man, I made a mistake. I bought one.
They circled
the worst thing I ever did.
Their rainbow color.
Best thing I did was sell it.
Thank you.
Take you to the bathroom.
That's all, folks.